In this tutorial, we will practice the procedure for a generator failure. Procedures shown may not be current or airline-specific, do not use for real-life flying. We start in cruise at 36,000 feet. As soon as we see the master caution light, the pilot flying announces, "My aircraft," indicating who is managing the aircraft. We note the electrical indication on the enunciator panel, which intentionally draws our attention to the overhead panel. We cancel the master caution light by pressing it and look up at the panel to see what the issue is. The amber source off light indicates the transfer bus electrical source has been disconnected. The source off checklist is called for. The pilot monitoring first checks to see if it is on the quick reference card, or QRC, which is kept on top of the glare shield. This card contains the immediate steps for more serious conditions. As the source off checklist is not on the QRC, the quick reference handbook, or QRH, is then used. Once the source off checklist has been located, the pilot monitoring reads the condition stated for the checklist, in this case that the transfer bus is not powered by the last selected source. Both pilots must concur that it is the correct checklist to use. Step 1 asks if both source lights are illuminated. They are not, so we move on to step 2. Step 2 directs us to check the affected generator switch is on. Step 3 depends on the result from the generator switch being confirmed on, did the source light extinguish or not? As it didn't, we go to the second option, which is correct, the source light is still illuminated, so we perform the action underneath it, which is to proceed to step 4. Step 4 directs us to start the APU, if available, and when running, to turn the APU generator switch on the affected side to on. The checklist now has us go to step 5. Step 5 depends on whether the source light is extinguished or not. It has extinguished, so option 1 is correct. The 4 black boxes underneath let us know we have now finished the procedure. If the source light was still illuminated, we would be directed to land at the nearest suitable airport. Let's build on what we've just seen, and notice what happens if we are using Autopilot A and loose generator 1. This time when the generator lost its source, the autopilot disconnected. We can select the other autopilot before calling for the source off checklist. The same thing happens when we are using Autopilot B and loose generator number 2. The pilot flying states, "My aircraft," and switches Autopilot A on. The source off checklist is then performed. Let's watch the procedure as it is run for the loss of generator 2. We can also use the AC and DC metering panel to check the output of each generator. Turning the knob to generator 1 shows no AC power. Both the APU generator and generator 2 show 45 amps and 115 volts. We hope you enjoyed learning about checklist usage and how a generator failure would be addressed. Please subscribe to be notified of our future tutorials.